some Wiz heroes. So obviously Heroes of the Storm. I don't know why I just said the Twitter handle there. That was dumb. But I'm going to be streaming some Heroes of the Storm here this afternoon. Probably just about 2 quick matches, so I can clear out my daily quests. And then I'll swap over to some Darkest Dungeon. Basically, what I was thinking about a lot while I was at work today was I want to do better at Darkest Dungeon. And last night playing was pretty rusty, pretty rough. So that's the plan. I'm going to start off with some quick matches. It perfectly ties in with Play 2 support and 2 Diablo. Plus, Auriel is like probably my favorite hero right now, if not one of my favorites. So I think that sounds like a plan. As always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to comment here on Twitch. If you're watching on YouTube at a later date, go ahead and follow me on Twitch so that way you can be notified every time I go live. I play a lot of Heroes of the Storm. I play now a little bit of Darkest Dungeon. I play some Mega Man. I play a lot of random things, pretty much. I'm not a dedicated streamer by any means, and I'm not a dedicated streamer in terms of a specific game, but I sure do like to play any video game for the most part, so at least that's where I'm coming from. Alright. I'm all set up for this. Now I just need to wait. Kind of hating the lighting in this room. I wonder if I might need to turn myself to get a bit better light situation going on. Let's give that a look. Yeah, basically I'm just casting a massive shadow on this side of my face. All right, Auriel, kind of the greenish Auriel, riding the blue elemental lizard, big old Kodo looking thing. And now I wait. We just have to wait here. Q is taking a little bit of time. I'm really kind of hoping for the last Machines of War event to occur here on the stream. That'd be great. All I need to do is collect 2 pieces of the artifact and I'll finally get my portrait. The Zelnaga artifact portrait. I have not been playing a lot of Heroes of the Storm lately. And what I have been playing is a lot of just quick AI speedrunning so that I can finish off my quests rather quickly. I have been playing a lot of WoW, but I'm also not very good at WoW. I'm still leveling up my Retribution Paladin, mostly just gearing up. I hit level 110 a few weeks ago, but I'm by no means ready to tackle too much in terms of the raid in Legion. And eventually this Q will pop, but for now, I guess we just have to be a little bit patient. I really honestly should be a little bit more flexible when it comes to Auriel, at least in terms of her build. I typically have a very standard build that maybe only changes a little bit on level 20, but level 1 I typically grab Swift Speed to increase the casting speed of Sacred Sweep. I also then, on level 4, increase the radius of Sacred Sweep. I go for the Energized Cord so that I can store up a lot of quick energy by myself if needed. It also augments as long as I'm, you know, bestowing hope on somebody else and near that other hero. This at least helps bring it up pretty quickly. Never take Resurrect, but I always take Crystal Aegis. Blinding Flash, now with that fast and very large Sacred Sweep, I can blind anybody in the middle for 3 seconds. Reservoir of Hope is just so good. You can heal at a ridiculous rate once you get a few stacks of Reservoir of Hope. And then I typically go for Shield of Hope. Sometimes Diamond Resolve is nice. If I'm protecting somebody and they're really low, the extra shield that they get as they come out of the Crystal Age is pretty helpful to keep them alive. Alright, Brax's Holdout. Oh, that sucks. We're going up against an Auriel who has a Cho'Gall. We've got a Thrall, an Abathur, and a Kael'thas. As long as stitches, I'll probably stick with either the Thrall or the Kael'thas. Most likely the Kael'thas. I like having Kael'thas here in Brax's Holdout, that's helpful. But whereas the Thrall has some self-sustain, a lot of self-sustain, honestly, Kael'thas doesn't. Stitches can heal himself as well. So if I stick with Kael'thas, that at least evens out the team so that we can stay healthy as we're split between the two different lanes. And there we go, Machine's War Event.
Hello. Zelnaga artifact pieces detected. Enemy SCVs are inbound to claim them. Collect the pieces for a reward. Congratulations. You have collected enough pieces.
Wonderful.
Returning
Got
to
the
battle.
Stimpak bonus as well as finished off my portrait. This is actually probably the first time that I've streamed Heroes of the Storm since I got my new graphics card. And I maybe should have bumped the graphics down a little bit. Hoping that this isn't too rough. That was fantastic body blocking.
Smash him all.
As was all day.
Less than a level ahead right now. I dove in there like an idiot. I don't know what I was doing there. Is there anything
the
I can bump down
while
we're
have to
playing?
Control
Probably
them.
not. Ooh, that's a bit of a delay.
Beacons have activated. Control them.
Okay, maybe that'll help out. Beacon progress. Nice, nice.
There is always
so I like this top is gonna be lost here. Honestly, I'm really surprised that they there we go. Should've all taken out. They forced Thrall to park back. It took them a while to react. Take care of that. Alright, 100 to
the
zero.
To deal with a much larger
I like that. I like that a lot. It's a little too late to save Chigall. I'm gonna back up. Okay, we had the wonderful surge wave, but if we decided to go out and try hiding them rather than pushing them, we lost a lot of ground.
Destruction complete.
Good, I'm liking this. Taking down their outer fortifications here, so it's kind of sweet. Have a nice head start on the push. I love my sacred sleep for just knocking out those cigar creeps.
Looks like the beacons are reactivating.
Okay, maybe about a half a level lead right now. I could not say it killed Boss. I tried. Did everything I could. Don't think I should really go up against. Oh, it's just Art. Alright. Plus, I have Aether on my side. Okay, beacon charging. Wonderful. Away for 1 second. Choke off of the other side of me. Yeah, I mean, I still think that. This could be a little smoother. Wonderful push by Stitches and our Zerg Force. Holy crap. That's fantastic.
With surety on purpose.
Wow, 29% on their core. This is happening much faster than I thought it would. And I'm all okay with that. Okay. Stitches is gone. Can maybe help Kael'thas take over. Could not save them. We were a little too far out. Thrall needs to get back. I think he's just gonna die. Making him chase and burn the ult would be great. But he probably could have just sat here and knocked that down as a death.
Power spike from the beacons. They'll be active soon.
Okay, so pretty much we should just be able to get a decent amount on our beacon, and that should signal the enemy. What we need to do is this right here. We need to be able to take Cho'Gath out. Are you kidding me? I didn't realize that their Auriel was attacked. That's not good at all. I'm dead. And I missed on my heal. Oh. Okay, so that's definitely what we didn't need. We did not need us to die and Cho'Gall to get resurrected. Crap. That completely threw me off. It was a strong use of resurrect. I had no idea that was going to happen, but that's my fault. That's not looking at what talents are being picked. We're all dead. We've got to hang back. We're gonna get picked off one by one now. Really want though is to be gaining stacks. I don't need any stacks right now. That was very, very sloppy, definitely, but it was a lot of fun still.
MVP.
29% siege damage. I'll go for that epic.
Epic. Epic.
Two epics. On a new side. Zelnaga artifact portrait has been completed. I'll change that here in a second, but go ahead and queue up for my next match. And there it is. Okay, what else could I potentially change? It was a fast queue. Okay. I think I'll leave it as it is. We have Auriel, Lieutenant Morales, Nova, Gaz, Oteriel. What an odd combination. I like their team a lot better. Yeah, I like their team a lot better. This should be interesting. Alright. Fast queue, fast loading screen.
Let's
help some people gain their artifacts.
Intervention is advised.
Keep it SCV. I guess you'll do it one day, but I have to lean by yourself.
Let the battle begin.
What an odd group. Nova, Tyrael, Gazlo, and then two support. They have so much more damage than us. Maybe we can heal that, but I don't know.
The ancient shrines awaken. Control them and let loose the Dragon Knight.
All right, Murden has joined the bottom lane here. Why are we people melee lane a little bit? Rolling three up top.
Hurry, activate the shrine, and the dragon's power is yours.
Four up top.
A worthwhile endeavor.
Oh, and Nova abandoned the bottom lane. That's good. Over. Okay, so three deaths on our side. That's not good. I mean, that is definitely less than ideal.
Have
courage. I've got to back out of here, otherwise I'm gonna die to emerge. I should have just abandoned this and headed towards the middle, I guess. Hunt me away. Okay, we are a level and a half down. That doesn't go well. Okay, spread out. We gotta soak.
There is always
try and catch up here. Okay, well, you failed on the gank, so you're welcome.
Barely so.
And we are still not soaking that top lane.
The shrines are gathering
a
power.
Bit of damage on,
the dragon
on that tower, maybe.
Calls from within.
Oh my god. Back off! That time the game was successful. It's also like one of the worst times for me to die where just the shrines pop up.
The Dragon Knight and slaughter your enemies with surety of purpose.
Okay, approaching two levels down, they're going to be able to push us around so easily. They already can, but once they get to 10, we're not going to come back from this. I mean, I don't exactly understand the matchmaking in terms of the distribution of roles here, but I guess they're doing something wrong. Stop me. Oh, Nova, go get it. Go get it. No, never mind. We lost top. Down over. Stay in mid to stop them. Oh, we were so close. Okay. Yeah, we just don't have the damage. So two levels down, top of that. Ouch. Ouch, ouch. Alright, so they'll get the dragon. Where are they gonna push? They're smart, they'll push bottom? They'll probably be wise in pushing it, since it's right there.
The light of the crystal arch shines on.
Two levels behind now. And yes, we're going to push mid. I'm going to try and clear this out for the XP. And help mid. But then we're focusing on everybody equally, and we're not pinning anyone down. Three levels down. Get some of these nerfs, probably. We're gonna make that decision. Poor Gazlo.
Gathers within the shrines. Unleash the dragon's wrath. Shall rest no longer. Unleash its power.
Gloriously done, friend.
Kill us. Hard up top.
Oh,
you jumped at just the perfect time, Auriel. Nice.
Attacking your core.
Going on.
Someone take this shield.
levels down. Honestly, I'm really surprised that this hasn't opened up more. I mean, lately we've been, like, actually sticking together, which is nice. But we're just gonna trade. They're going to take the bottom, we'll take the top. Still three levels down. You're gonna take the dragon. They'll probably march it right up the middle. Although the top keep is completely destroyed. That's all five of us.
In the face of adversity, hope's light shines the brightest.
You shall burn.
Yep. Well, directly down the middle, while the rest of the team pushes top. It keeps us busy. Oh! Okay, dragon's gonna die. This will be good. Nice, butcher kill. I honestly didn't even see them. Alright, this is not. But bottom and mid are definitely sitting in some rough spots here. And we're just gonna chase, that's basically what we're gonna do, apparently. We could be taking these merc camps while we have some time. I mean, we might be able to help catch up a bit of the SP if we can knock out some of these supports. Crystallize myself, and that was not happening. That was just too slow.
Soon the shrine shall awaken.
Take the Dragon Knight's power. Your core is under attack.
Oops. I meant to say never.
Four.
to giving up. Sometimes I might entertain the thought of getting absolutely killed. We are. But at the same time, like, it's a video game. It's supposed to be fun. Just have fun with it. I do not take kind of paper. Oh no! We were doing so well and I just got targeted by the freaking speed. And all of my abilities up and ready to go. Happened so quickly. This, my friends, is why you never give up. We almost had a nice turn there. They were trickling in. We were killing them like just one at a time, little bits here and there, and then I started the backwards part of that turn. The downward spiral where I died to that key. I did what I could. I tried to save up. Fun one.
None are spared the flame.
It's a little demoralizing, sure. But it was fun.
MVP.
I mean, I don't know. I know Ethereum was pretty legit. Okay, whew, so much more healing than I had. Unfortunate. Alright, well, that takes care of my daily quests, so I'm good for a few days here. So I think I'm going to end the current stream for right now. I'm going to take just a couple minutes for a break, and then I'm going to swap over to Darkest Dungeon. So if anyone's tuning in, thank you for watching. If you want to see Darkest Dungeon, stay tuned in, I guess, or kind of hang around for a couple of minutes. I'm going to try and deal with this lighting situation, as well as just go to the bathroom, get a drink, things like that. So thank you for watching some Heroes of the Storm, and hopefully I'll see you here in a little bit.